And as always, seated tall and straight, close the eyes, bring the attention inward. Nothing to do, nothing to seek. Everything we need is only within. Let's begin with the sound of Om three times to attract divine attention. Imagine you are everywhere. Fix your mind on God alone. Rest your thoughts in God alone. And in God you will live hereafter. Of this there is no doubt. May all beings everywhere be happy and free from suffering and enjoy this practice through our senses. Let's come to standing. So we'll start off by chanting the mantra for purification to purify the space, the grounds, and all the psychic channels within. If you know the chant, you may chant along. If not, you just listen to the words and think about the intention of purification and you derive all the benefits. Om pavitraha pavitra va sa va vashtanga tulpi va yaha smritpantrikaksham sa bahya pyantraha sachi. Release the arms. Open up the feet about 10 inches, bring your arms up, the palms facing in, charging breathing. Inhale from the soles of feet right up through the body to the fingertips. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold the attention of the breath at the fingertips. Draw all the prana there, all the vital force. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale all the way back down through the body. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. Inhale, imagine the earth's energy rising up through the body, charging it up. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Holding at the fingertips, hold the breath. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale all the way back down to the soles of the feet. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Last time, draw the earth's energy right up through the body. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Holding at the fingertips, suspend the breath. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All the way back down. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bring your arms down now. We'll continue some exercises to help purify the body, oxygenate the blood, and aerate the lungs. So breathe vigorously through these exercises. But let's first start by rolling the head in circles. Try to make the ears touch the shoulders, the chin right come right down on the chest, and the back of the head touch the top of the back. Move at the speed that you're comfortable at. And then switch the direction of rotation. And release. Now inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale down. Continue. Now inhale, pull the arms up. Exhale, pull down. Inhale and exhalation is through the nose. Inhale, extend forward. Exhale, retract. And now sweep, swing the arms back and forth. Conclude. Arms across the chest, squeeze tightly. Throw the arms back. Alternate the cross each time, one arm over the other, and then switch. Bring your arms up over the head on the inhale. Exhale, toss the body down. Last one, just stay hanging down. Allow the body to stop bouncing around. And slowly roll your way up. Keep the head down and heavy. And then when the shoulders come back, the head comes back up. Raise your arms up over the head. Inhale, exhale. Come down into a squat. Just go as low as your knees can tolerate. Always remember to move according to your condition. Right back up. And then pull the elbows out to the side, twisting from side to side now. Exhaling as you complete the twist on each side. Next one, four movements, also incorporates a squat. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, pull down. Inhale, straight back up. Exhale, swing down. Let's do it together. Do the practice with enthusiasm to make it the best offering possible to all beings. Last one. And now, arms out in front. This is the exhale starting position. Inhale, circle the arms around backwards, right to the front again. Exhale, pull in and punch right back out. Let's go. And then the next one. Very similar, except the arms start down and it's a circle and a quarter. Inhale all the way around to the front. Exhale, pull in and drop the arms back down. And release. Open up the feet a little bit wide, the toes point out beyond the edges of the mat. We're going from side to side. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, bend to the right. Inhale, right arm up. Bend to the left. And conclude. Next one is similar, but we're holding as we lean. Inhale, left arm comes up and carries you over to the right. Hold the breath as you reach your maximum bend. Exhale, come back. Right arm up, inhale, go all the way to the right, the left, hold it, and release. Continue. Imagine you have weights attached to the fingers, pulling you down deeper. Lose yourself in the sensations. Remember that you're transmitting your benefits to all beings. Imagine everyone and everything experiencing the practice through your own body. So make the experience as beneficial as possible. Don't go to the place of pain or anxiety. This is not what you want to transmit. All the movements done gracefully. Imagine that you're the witness watching your body, and when you imagine your body moving with grace and ease, this will transpire in your movements. Let's go for one more on each side. Release. Come down onto the hands and knees now. Cat, cow. Inhale, arch the back, send the chest forward, away from the seat. Exhale, round the back, tuck the tail under, push the heart right up between the shoulder blades. Inhale, stretch the belly skin. Exhale, stretch the back skin. Inhale, the shoulder blades sink towards one another. Exhale, they pull away from one another. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, a sit bone spread. Exhale, they pull right back together. Inhale, exhale, fire up the core muscles. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. And now raise your right leg up. Inhale, exhale. Swing it out to the right. And then the other side. Left leg up, swing it out to the left. And release. Now walk forward, come on to the belly. Take a moment to relax here, breathe in, breathe out all fatigue. Now join the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers. We're going to come up with just the chest rising up. Inhale, exhale, pull down. So engage the buttocks and the upper back muscles. Inhale, and down, exhale. Up, down, anchor through the low body. And down, up, and down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down, and relax. Breathe in, breathe out. Next one. Arms out in front. I'll demonstrate this one, then I'll give a modification. We're throwing the legs up, so legs coming down. Useful moments of the legs coming down and the hips pressing down for to allow the body to rise up. If it's too much, inhale, lift the arms and legs like so, and down. Okay, so let's go for 10.
Exhale, relax. Drop all of the tea out of the body. And then push your way up into table, then back into child's pose, a seat behind the heels. The next movement has four, next sequence has four movements. Inhale, come up into high cat. Exhale to cobra. Hips down between the hands, roll the head back. Inhale, back up. Exhale, seat all the way back behind the heels. So let's continue. Inhale up. Exhale, forward, shoulders back. Back up, inhale. Exhale, return to child. Up, forward, up, and back. Up, forward. Rounding, forward, arching, rounding again, flattening and lengthening, and up, forward, up, and back, up, forward, up, and back, up, forward, hold the hands, get the chest for the forward, up and back, up, forward. Make sure you don't hyperextend the elbows, elbow joints, and back. Two more, up, forward. Keep the back neck long, the lower back for your wrinkles if you can, and back. Last time, up, forward. And back, and rest here. Inhale, exhale, soften. The next one, we're going to come forward on the inhale into the cobra and then hold it with the pose. So inhale, glide the belly between the, come forward between the arms, hold the pose. Exhale, back. Alternatively, come from up above, drop your hips between your hands, hold it there, and back. So do whichever entry you like. Move smoothly, glide, inhale, four, and back. Come forward, inhale. Watch the body moving like you're the witness. Come forward. Bring the head all the way back. Open up the throat and the heart. And back. And again. Pause here. Hold it. And return. Pull forward. Use the arms to help you move with more ease and power. And back and forward. Think of the cobra. Moves with grace but with extreme power. And back and forward. And back. And again. Imagine having no limits to your range of motion. You can only go as far as your imagination. So cultivate it so that it's boundless. And back. And then again. And forward. And back. Stay there. Inhale. Exhale, relax. And then come forward onto the belly again. Flip right onto the back. So we're doing extensions and tucks here. Inhale, extend through the legs. Pull the arms over the head. Exhale, come into tuck. Squeeze the sides into the chest. Chin to the knees. Inhale, extend. Push up through the heels. Stretch to the fingertips. Exhale again, tuck. yourself as compact as possible. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Squeeze tight. Push your lower back into the mat. Inhale. Exhale. Push all the air out of the body with the thighs to help. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And then release. Breathe in. Breathe out. Start again. Inhale, extend. This time hold the breath as you tuck. Exhale to release. Inhale again, lengthen. Hold and tuck. Press the thighs into the belly, the chin on the knees. Release, exhale. Inhale, stretch as much as you can. Pull in and hold. Release. Inhale, stretch and hold the breath, come into the tuck. Exhale, release. Inhale, stretch, hold and tuck. Release, exhale. Inhale, hold and tuck. And release, exhale. Inhale, stretch, hollow out the navel, pull the thighs to the body, forehead even to the knees. Exhale, last time. Inhale, stretch, hold and tuck. And release. Inhale, exhale, relax. Now we're going to do little halasana rolls and then into forward bend. So it looks like this. Bring the legs over the head. Inhale. Hold the breath as you bring the legs down. Pull the body up. Exhale. Drape your body over the legs. So if you need, you can use the momentum of the legs coming and the hips coming down to pull yourself up. If you have the strength, wait till your feet are down before you come up so that your feet are on the ground when you come up. So begin, go at your own speed. Modify as you need to. Try to move as smoothly as possible. Through the movements. You don't have to go all the way over your head. Just go to where you can. You're just rocking back and forth a little bit. On the back is fine. Do one more. The next time, bring your legs over the head again. Bend your knees as you start to come down. Plant the feet. And see if you come right up to standing. Okay, so now we're going to continue the practice of Surya Namaskara. So make your way to the top of the mat. You're there, bring your hands to the heart center, close the eyes. Remember to come back to the intention of offering up the practice. Do the practice as though it were your divine duty to all beings everywhere. Let's move together as one to stay in a collective mind. reach the arms up over the head. Come down into forward fold. Bend the knees if you need to, bring your hands flat on the ground. Then the right foot slides back into a lunge. Sink down through the seat to lower the knee down. Come into high plank. Knees, chest, and forehead down. And then brush your nose ground as you come forward between your arms, coming up into cobra. Roll over the toes, back into downward facing dog. Lift the seat up and back. Right foot steps to the hands. If that's too much, if it's too difficult, bring the left knee down first. Right foot doesn't make it all the way, just use the right hand to assist it forward. Sink through the seat again. Bring the feet forward, left foot forward to meet the right. Chest on the thighs, head down. Come all the way up. Hands back to the heart. Press the hips forward, lengthen the whole front of the body. Arms up over the head. Come down gracefully. Fold the body in half. A left foot back into a lunge. Sink through the seat again. Into the plank. Knees, chest, forehead down. Keep the elbows close to the body. Pull the body forward. Chest open, head back. Back into Uddha Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Then the left foot steps quietly forward to the hands. Feet together, Uttanasana, chest on the legs, head down. Come all the way up. And bring the hands back to the heart. Don't worry about the breath. Just move the body in a way that's intuitive, that allows the breath to remain steady and even. Right foot back. And then the breath will work with you, delivering ease and movement and gracefulness. Lower the chest down between a little bit behind the hands, and then glide forward between the arms. Shoulders back. Back into downward facing dog. Right foot steps forward, sink down to the seat. Feet together. Bow to the legs. Adjust your humbleness. Come all the way up, hips forward, stretch the whole front of the body. And then return home, Pranamasana. Arms up. Go down. Lose yourself in the sensations. Left foot back. Into the plank. Lower down, move in a way that's smooth, that doesn't agitate the witness who is watching. Make the experience as graceful and pleasant as possible. Left foot steps forward to the hands. Feet together. Pull the body down onto the legs. Come all the way up and back. Let's add on. Reach the arms up over the head. Come forward and down. Bend the knees, chest comes to the thighs, hands behind the back. Extend the chest forward and then push the body, the legs back with your body. Uttanasana, head comes down. Release the hands beside your feet, right foot back. Lower the back knee down, slip through the seat. Raise your arms up over the head. Kapi asana, make a crescent shape, moon with the shape of the body. Crescent moon shape. Then bring the hands down, step back into plank. Knees, chest, forehead down. Glide between the arms, come up into cobra. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Right foot steps, back knee down. Raise your arms up over the head. Every movement reflecting devotion and love and surrender. Chest on the sides, hands behind the back, join them together, extend and dive the head down. Uttanasana, gesture of humbleness. Release the hands, bring them all the way over the head and back to the heart. Arms up, go down. Join the belly to the legs, hands together, extend, and then plunge down. Bring the hands back down beside your feet, left foot back, lower the knee, sink the seat, arms over the head, crescent moon, Kapi Asana. And then back down with the hands, step back into plank, Ashtanga Namaskar, knees, chest, forehead down, and then come forward into the cobra. Back into downward facing dog. Pay equal attention to every form. Left foot down, in front, raise your arms over the head, and bring the hands back. Beside the feet, right foot slips in beside the left. Chest on the thighs, join the hands, extend, and then pull down. Dive down deeply. Release, come all the way up and back, and then back home. Another variation, arms up, arch the back a little bit if you can, and bring the hands back down to the ground. Shift your weight forward, shoulders or the fingertips, push into the hands, lift up a little bit, and then just allow the toes to glide back, bend the elbows as you come back. You can walk back alternatively, hover just above the ground. Then push into your hands, come forward into upward facing dog. Pull the chest forward, shoulders back, lift the hips and knees away from the ground. Feel as though you're howling at the moon like a dog. Try to picture each form that you're trying to imitate and trying to make your body copy that image in your mind. Now push into the hands, take the seat all the way up and back, Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog, feel like a dog stretching its back. Bounce the chest a little bit, try to flatten the arms, top of the head comes towards the ground, and the belly towards the sides. Exhibit the loyalty that the dog shows to its master. And then lift the heels, bend the knees, look at the space between your hands, push into your hands, bring your feet forward, hopping or walking. Pull the body down onto the legs, Uttanasana, seat lifts up. Come all the way up to standing now. Hands back to the heart. Let's do one more like that. Raise your arms over the head, stretch the front of the body. Come down gracefully. Hands plant down. Again, keep strong through the arms, push down into the ground. Back into chaturanga, hopping or walking. Come forward and up into the upward facing dog. Lose yourself in the pose. Try to come into the body, whatever you're representing. In every sense, the mindset, the virtues, the qualities. And then back into downward facing dog. Soften the line of the back. Soften in every sense of the word. Keep the heart open. Then lift the heels, bend the knees, look at the space in your hands. Push into your hands and bring the feet forward smoothly, hopping or walking. Pull the body down onto the legs. Come all the way up to standing. Arch back. Hands back to the heart. Stay for a moment. Breathe in. Exhale, let go of all attachments to the results, let go of all expectations. Keep doing a practice as though it just must be done. And release the hands. So let's do some standing postures now. So let's try a little bit of a flow for a balance sequence. Stand firmly on the left foot. Take the right foot up. And see if you can place it into your tree. You can do the normal tree with your foot against the inseam. If you have more flexibility, you can bring the edge of the foot into the left hip crease, coming into your lotus. If you're having trouble balancing, you can keep your toes on the ground if you need to. Turn the knee out. So do whichever expression you like. Push the foot firmly into the thigh for the conventional tree. And then raise your arms up over the head, grow tall. Pull the navel up and in, hollow out the navel. Gaze up if you like, if you have the good balance. Whatever happens, be unconcerned. If you fall out, just come right back up, keep trying. It's the effort that's most important. Good, then from here we're going to come into Natarajasana. Take hold of the left foot, the right foot, and just see if you can pull it even level with the knee. Bend the standing leg a little bit, see if you can float it there. If it's too much, just bring, rest the foot on your thigh. Bring the right hand, wrist over the left. Make sure your elbows don't drop down. Keep them at the same height. Think of the dancing Shiva statue. Make your body look just like. And from here, press into your right, left foot, come up higher with the knee. See if you can wrap
your legs together. So push the right thigh against the left. Twist a little bit, you might be able to hook your foot. If you can't, don't worry about it. And then a left arm goes over the right, eagle pose. Push the elbows out further, and if you can't, sink down. Concentrate on stillness. Fix the gaze like an eagle. Intense. And then come back up. Release. Try it on the other foot. Imagine yourself moving with grace and ease throughout the whole sequence. Whatever happens, be unconcerned. Remain unjudging. Place your left foot in position, either your half lotus if you like, or your regular tree at the height you want. Don't worry about getting right up to the root if it doesn't go there. Just do your best. Pull the navel in and up. Take your gaze up. Always expressing humbleness, surrender to service, to selfless service. Coming down, take hold of the right foot, try to pull up a little bit higher so it's about the height of the knee. If it doesn't rest, stay there, don't worry about it, just do your best. Again, bend the standing leg, arms out to this side, and then left wrist over the right. Keep the body upright, fingers pointing in a straight line up and down. Sink a little bit deeper, lower if you can. Work the hips. Then push into the right leg to come back up. Lift the left knee up higher so that when the thigh comes down on the standing leg, it's nice tight wrap. And then you can twist a little bit, hook the foot, and then the right arm over the left this time. Shoulders in line with the hips as much as you can. Press back up to release. Good. Now from here, stand in mountain pose, tall and supreme, and bring the index fingers in line with the elbows in one line. And then jump the feet apart, wide angle. Turn to the left immediately for warrior two. Sink down through the seat, shoulders down. Exude the courage and the determination and the leadership of the warrior. Now from here, Paschimottanasana. You can start by bringing your left forearm resting on the left thigh and right arm over the head. Make sure the right hip is not jutting up and out. Sink it down a little bit so you have a straight line from the back foot right up to the fingertips. Pull the right shoulder back. Option here. You can take the right arm around the back. Press the hand into the thigh. If you have a little bit more flexibility, you can bring the left shoulder down against the knee and wrap the left arm underneath the leg. Right arm goes over the back, take a bind. Pull the body back, shoulders aligned, one on top of the other. Good. And from here, release. Bring the left fingertips down in front. From here, push into your fingertips, push into the front foot, slide the right foot in. If you can, raise your right leg up. If you need, you can. If you have a block handy, you can place a block underneath your left hand to give yourself more height. Adho Chandrasana. Look to the right, look in front of you, and then the right arm comes up perhaps too. Try to get the right leg higher. And then bring the right foot down. Bring the right fingertips down to the ground as well. Turn forward, back knee down, sink down to the seat. Kapyasana. Raise your arms up over the head, pull the body up out of the hips, sink the shoulders down, wiggle the shoulders back. Think of a crescent moon shape and just copy that image in your mind with your body if you can. Imagine the index fingers going over the back knee. Stretch the body like you're an elastic band. Leap to the chest, come back up. Press into the front knee, push your way up. Slide your right foot in, bend the toes under on the back foot. Right hand comes to the outside of the left knee, left hand to the sacrum. Inhale, push the lower back up and in. Turn to the left. If you can, you can lean back. Press the fingertips against the outside of the heel. Touch through your shoulders so the chest is facing the long edge of the mat. You can stay here or progress to the next, proceed to the next one. Turn back forward. Right arm up, we'll do it this way so you can see. And then angle the toe and knee towards the right. Anchor the leg in place with the right arm. Elbow to the outside of the knee. Hands get at the heart. Maybe even a left fist pushing into the right hand. And then pull the body up as you push down, hand into hand. Center of the chest comes to the thumbs and roll the left shoulder all the way back. Those of you who want to go further into a bind, go ahead. Make sure the elbow's in the space underneath the knee. Left arm comes. You can use the left hand first to push the elbow on the elbow so the hand to guide the hand through underneath. And then join hands against the belly underneath the body. Left shoulder rolls back. Of course, if you want to take your knee up off the ground, go ahead. Bend the toes under. Get your left shoulder all the way back, eventually to the same height as the other one. Chest is looking right up. Break the pose, bring the right knee down. From here, back into easy warrior two. Open up the chest to the right, arms out. And then circle the hands down to the ground, hips and shoulders facing forward, move the left foot out to the long edge of the mat, and then rock back and forth, pushing off the toes. Push the right foot back, heel back, and then lower the knee down, relax the toes. If you can come down onto the forearms. Roll to the right, right forearm down, roll back to the left forearm might come down. Now fix the gaze, keep on even gaining from the toes all the way to the top of the head. Anchor down through the hips. If you're very flexible, you can take your left arm to the outside and bring the chest right on the ground. Keep the knee close to the shoulder. Knee is over the foot. Now from here, and come back onto the hands, bend the toes under, scooch the right knee in, left foot moves back behind. Come into a modified side plank, push the hips forward. Good. And if you want, you can tuck your right, push into your right hand, push the left foot underneath, tuck it underneath, come into side plank, push the hips forward and up. If you know other variations of this pose, you can come right into wild pose, wild thing, slide your left toes back alongside the right knee, and then turn the hips and chest more. Spin on your hands a little bit, on the heel of the palm. Come back into side plank. And then bring the left hand back down alongside the right. Now we're facing dog. From here, raise the left leg up. And then step the foot between the hands. Spin on your feet, so facing the long edge of the mat again. Toes, feet are parallel, arms out to the side, come up. And then turn to the right, warrior two again. Shoulders down, long lines here. This sense of forward movement. It's like the warrior leading the troops into battle. Pashvakonasana. You can bring the right arm to rest on the right thigh, pull the left shoulder back, turn the chest up, curl the right side of the seat under, or go into other expressions. A half bind, perhaps, pull the left shoulder back as you press the right hand into the thigh, opening up a little bit, or drop the shoulder down to the height of the knee so you can get the right arm more easily underneath the leg. Join your hands behind the back. If you can, take your left wrist with your right hand. Your condition as always, back leg stays strong. And from here, release the bind if you have it. Right hand comes in front of the right foot, push into that right foot and right hand, fingertips to slide your left foot in. Again, here's where you might want to block. Place your hand on the block, raise the left leg up, perhaps take the right left arm up. Chandrasana. Just do your best. Make any modifications you need to. Bend the standing leg, bring the left foot back down quietly, left hand down. Turn to face front of the mat, lower the knee, sink down to the seat. Arms up over the head. Shoulders come up towards your ears, but then they drop right back down. Feel the shoulder blades sinking down the back. Arms go back. Kapyasana. Keep the arms beside the head as close as possible. Keep the arms straight. Fingertips of the index finger in line with the rest of the arms. The heart come back up, right, push into the front knee, come higher up, shoulders over the hips, bend the toes under and back foot, legs like a box, left hand to the outside of the right knee, other hand on the seat, inhale, push the lower back up and in, rise up by the hips, turn to the right, lean back a little bit if you want, take the fingertips, press against the outer heel. Keep on trying to rise up. Don't shrink down into your hips. Then if you want to go further, turn forward, left arm up, go to the outside of the right leg. Sukha Parivritta Pashvakonasana. As you push the right hand to the left, see how my body comes up higher, so the belly is higher than the thigh. And then this gives you more room to spin. Keep on trying to get this in the chest to come to the thumbs. Imagine you're eventually trying to look like you're lying on your back. Take other expressions as you know them for advanced practitioners. You can take a bind. Take the left knee up off the ground too if you like. Always explore your potential. Go to the edge of your potential. Every time, and then you keep redefining your edge and make progress. Break the pose, left knee down, come all the way back up and gracefully land back into warrior two. Bring the hands down to the ground, hips and shoulders facing forward, and then rock back and forth, sink through the seat. Try to get your hips to come down. Then push back to the left heel, lower the knee, flatten out the toes. Can, if your shoulders are at the height of the knee, roll to the left, bring the left form down, and then to the right, so the right side comes down as well. Now fix the gaze like a lizard. Try not to blink. Stay heavy through the hips. Once, if you have the mobility, go right down
flat on the chest. Find the ease in the pose by just trying to tap into the consciousness, all the virtues and the form of it, the body of the physical body of what you're representing. Make your way back up. Scooch the back knee in, the left knee, bend the toes under, and the right foot slides back. Coming into your modified side plank. Push your hips forward, your hands low in front of the shoulders, give you more power to keep the arms strong. Make sure you don't drop into the shoulder. Keep your neck long, and then if you want, keep pushing into your left hand, slide your left foot underneath the right. Vasistasana. Place the right foot in front or slide it back alongside the left knee. Spin on your hand, flip your hips and chest face up. Keep the left arm strong, make sure you're not dropping to the shoulder again. And then return. Keep your hips high, keep pushing into your left heel, the palm, you turn to downward facing dog. And then the right foot steps, let's raise the right leg up first behind you, one-legged dog, and then step the foot between your hands. Spin on your feet, toes facing long edge of the mat, then the arms out to the side, come all the way up. Join hands to the heart. From the heart, inhale up to the space between the eyebrows. Exhale, back down to the heart. Remain established in divine love. And from here, arms out to the side for a moment. Jump back to mountain. From here, lower your body down. Head comes down. Hands come down and then roll the seat down. Come on to the knees. So starting off with hair pose here, place the forehead down, try to bring the forehead close to the knees as possible. You can have your hands, palms down beside your feet, and then lift your seat. As your seat lifts up, your hands might drag forward a little bit. Try to come with your seat directly over the knees, so you're more on the back of the head. If it's too much, doesn't feel comfortable at all, so just place. Don't go as far, or you can walk your head forward a little bit so that you can still have your hips over your knees. Those you want to go into headstand, you can take whatever expression of your arms you want. You can place your hands beside your knees, turn your fingers around so your fingers are facing behind, and then pressing your fingertips, lift up your seat, walk your feet a little bit forward, left leg goes back. And if you want, you can just pulse up and down, coming off your heel. Then she may be coming right up off your front foot. Bend the toes back, your toes lift up. Eventually, keep pushing through the left foot, and you might be able to come with your legs more even in height. Go to a place where you find steadiness. Remember that what you're trying to offer up is the best experience possible. If you're more advanced, you can try to come up off your fingers one at a time. For professionals, as Dharma says, maybe come right onto your index fingers, the very tip. Coming back down gracefully. Come back into child's pose. Breathe in. Breathe out. Soften. Then roll your way up. Bring your legs forward. Come onto your back. Good. Take a moment here. Inhale,
Exhale, imagine you're fainting, release all effort. And then bring your feet, slide your feet towards the body. Lift your feet so you can take hold of your ankles, and then place your feet right by your seat. Edges the feet in line, the hips roughly. Take your hands beside your feet, lift up your hips. Tuck your shoulders underneath. If your hands can hold on to the ankles, you can do this. And then pull on the ankles at the same time. Try to get your chest towards your chin. Try to imagine where your knees are. Your front of your knees should not be over the toes. Try to lift your hips so that your chest looks like a wall and the backs and knees are in line with the heels. Try to picture where your knees are. Feel where they are. Look at your body and your mind. Now you can come into Iron Bridge if you like. If you want to try that, you join your hands together. Tuck your shoulders under a little bit so your wrists are together. Squeeze your hands tight and then walk one foot forward. Press into your arms, your upper arms, your shoulders. Bring the other foot forward to meet it. Roll the thighs inwards. Try to get your toes to plant down. So you're like a low iron bridge. Even curve from the neck all the way down to the toes. Remember, this is an option. Now from here, depending where you are, you can place your hands, turn your hands so the hands are flat on the ground, and then just lower your seat down right onto your hands. If your knees are underneath, your feet are underneath the knees, you can still do this. Tuck your shoulders under a little bit. And then from here, push into the lower arms, lift the chest and bring the top head to the ground. We're in fish pose now. Now breathe very fast and nose like a sniffing dog. Keep going with a breath. If you want, raise your legs 12 inches off the mat. Lower the legs down and come out of the pose. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now from here, we're going to raise the arms over the head, come up to seated position. Bend your knees if you like, Paschimottanasana. Lift the toes, keep the heels on the ground, reach up, hinge forward, bring your chest, your belly onto your thighs, take hold of your feet, push through the base of the big toe, and then inhale. Keep on trying to bring the chest forward. Exhale, pour more weight into the legs. Keep your attention at the base of the spine. Those you can, you can get your legs on the ground, go ahead. Pull the heels forward, legs flat on the ground. The body stays with your legs. Keep your attention at the base of the spine. It might attract all the blood there. If you want to take other binds with your hands, take hold of one wrist with the other hand in front of the heels. I invite you to do so. Slide your hands back behind the seat, fingers facing away. Purvottanasana. Slide your heels in a little bit so the knees come up. And then lift up your hips. Try to get your chest higher than the shoulders. Roll the thighs inwards so the toes plant down. If it's too much, bench pose. The heels come underneath the knees. Try not to sag through the body, the hips. Push them up. Head back and then bust a streak of breath again. your chin in, lower the seat down. Good. From here, we're going to cross the ankles, come onto the knees. Lower the forearms down onto the ground, tiger pose. Bring the right leg up. Imagine someone's pulling on the foot, trying to get as far back and up as possible. No wrinkles in the lower back. Keep pushing your chest forward. Bend the knee. See if you can take hold of your left hand to the right foot. Pull it up higher. Push the chest forward. Heel in towards the seat, release other leg. The hips directly over the knees, raise the left leg up. Again, try to get lots of extension in the lower back by pulling the foot up as high as you can, as far back as you can. Try to keep the legs straight. Then bend the knee. Keep pressing to the left forearm so you can take the right hand up to the foot. Pull the foot up higher. Push the foot into the hand, try to get as far back as you can, away from the head. Pull the heel in and release. Good. From here, draw the seat back. On the heels, forehead to the ground, and roll your way up. Right hand behind the seat, left hand to the outside of the right knee. Inhale, lift up through the chest. Exhale, turn to the right. Pull on the left, the right side with your left hand. Keep your back straight. Turn the chest all the way to the right, chin over the right shoulder eventually. Visualize the spiraling action of the spine. Release, go to the other side. Left hand behind the seat, right hand to the outside of the left knee. Inhale, lift, exhale, pull on the left leg, turn more to the left. Make sure your back is not hunching, shoulders back. Pose, come down onto your back for Shavasana. So lie down gently. And when you're all the way down, just relax the body. Just allow all the tension to melt away. Deep breath in, exhale, imagine you're fainting. Just soften everything. Feel as though all the muscles became like jello. The skin and the muscles just hanging off the bones. Body feeling as a result heavy, sinking into the ground. Surrender completely. All effort. Let go of all tension. And the body becomes receptive to receiving all the efforts and love you put out there through your own practice. Comes back to you. Imagine imagine yogis everywhere, all around the world, practicing exactly like you are, delivering benefits. Tap into their strengths as well. Draw in all their gifts. Just imagine you're everywhere. Feel connected to all beings. Keep sending out your love and all that you drew in from the practice to them as well. Exclude no one or nothing. We are all one. We're all reflections of God. Cultivate unconditional love, reverence, appreciation, and compassion for all beings. Through passing through all of their forms and all their experiences. Cultivating that knowledge by coming back to the practice, trying to tap more and more into those life forms, their consciousness, deeper and deeper every time. To love them is to love yourself more deeply and to love the highest self as well. More deeply, for that highest self, God, resides in all beings. Prepare to come back from Shavasana in a way that is gentle, quiet, mindful. Make your way back up to a seated position. Make ready to just keep sending out your love in all your day-to-day activities. The practice extends beyond the mat. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Be receptive to the divine grace within. Namaste. Thank you for joining. Have a wonderful day. Next week we're back to Wednesday. Thank you. I appreciate your understanding for the day change today. See you next time.